I'm happy that some of you at least are able to be present because a lot of other activities are going on, and so I didn't want to disturb the others. I just give you a brief, resume of what the book is, and then after that I will request Father Provincial to kindly release the book and hand over the first copy to Father Nirmal Mathew, our economist. Well, before releasing, if he likes to say one or two words, that is up to him. Then he releases the book. Then after that, I will hand over a couple of copies to the fathers here. The others maybe later. That will be the very short procedure. The title of the book is Heart Springs, A Journey Through Musings from the Depths. Type: inspirational literature. Content: assorted with various topics and themes, 30 topics in all. It is divided into three sections. First, biblical musings. Two, collective echoes. Three, soulful reveries. It is printed and published by the Media House, Delhi. Inspiration behind the book, someone asked me. I said, maybe I will just say that. Okay. Fulfill the dream of writing a second book after my first gleanings in 2015. Encouragement given by some close friends. Firm resolve to productively use COVID-19 pandemic time. What can you take away from the book? All age groups can take away something, take something home. Ancient Egyptians believed that upon death, they would be asked only two questions, and their answers would determine whether they could continue their journey in the afterlife. The first question was, did you find joy? If yes, the second question would be, or was, did you bring joy to others? So, the purpose of this book is to bring some joy to others. The book is to help people in general to find meaning in their life. There is a long meditation on parousia, aging and the end of life, probably the longest chapter. The need for empathy, or what is called introspection in society. Be a giver than a receiver in your life. The necessity of maximum utilization of time, which is the most precious treasure, I would think, after life and our parents and so on. Synergy. How synergy can accomplish more and great things in life. And finally, one more point. Farewells are part and parcel of life. At this moment, I would like to thank Reverend Father Provincial, Father Dr. Jose Kuruvachira, SDV, for being present here to release my book, Heart Springs. I do appreciate your presence, Father, and the time spent for this. I'd like to thank Father Nebu Mathew, our provincial economist, for being here. I am deeply grateful to Father K.O. Sebastian, our principal, Father Joseph Thottapullil, our administrator, Father Sunny Minch, our warden and vice principal, for their support and encouragement to make this book see the light of day. I do appreciate the help extended to me by Mr. John Brito, who helped me with the desktop and all the designing, the cover design. All the sisters who are collaborating with us, many of you are here, thank you very much. And all the DBC faculty members, some of you are here, thank you very much. Towards the realization of this dream, once again, thank you and God bless you all. Now I request Reverend Father Provincial, Father Joseph Kuruvachira to release the book.
Good morning to everyone. Before releasing the book, I would like to congratulate Father Sebastian Jose for authoring his second book. And he belongs to the dying species of authors. And he has tried his best to keep alive the species. And I must thank him very specially for that, especially for making use of the pandemic time very fruitfully. I had the privilege of going through the manuscript of this book some time back, and I was really impressed by many of his thoughts. And as he said, there is something for everyone in this book. From the young person to the oldest, you'll find biblical passages and reflections on the Bible. You'll find secular topics, something for youth, something for children, something for the old. And you'll also find a lot of personal sharings. And when you read that, you'll notice that he's sharing with